So it is very important that when you establish a committee, you facilitate the establishment of a committee. You should get the committee members. I know the issues of land can be very important. I knew that if I don't get the committee members to know what their mandate is, and to know how far they can go in working with the chief, because you know they are going to share power. Sharing power is not very easy. And so you need to get the committee to understand that they have a limit to which they can go without necessarily jeopardizing or giving up their right to talking about the issues. And at the same time, you have to let them know what the mandate is, what your vision, or what together your collective vision should be for the committee that you are establishing. And the collective vision was to get women involved in land decision-making processes, and then to also ensure that they access and secure land for, you know, agricultural purposes. And so it's very important for all of us to begin to know that if I have my mandate and I can work within my mandate. And so for the CLDC, knowing their mandate and knowing the vision and the objective of the establishment of that particular committee has actually worked for them. So far, we have not had any issue of conflict between the committee and the traditional authority. That is because we put a representative of the traditional authority on the committee. And so, if there is anything, if anybody should come outside the committee and tell the chief anything, all he needs to do is to contact his representative to find out whether this was what happened or this was what, you know, the discussions that were taken at the committee level. And so it will reduce a lot of conflict. So we took them through conflict management, even among themselves. They could agree to disagree or disagree and disagree. You understand? So, and they could bring conflict in their distance. So we took them through a lot of training. Initially, we were supported by the Participatory Development Associates, where we did the training for them. But NetRight also coming on board together with the IIED has also helped in building their capacity. We have had a training session where land rights, you know, the new land bill was even explained to them. And we have also had committee engagements, committee conversations. And as we are having the conversations, the issues have been addressed. And that is how empowering the committee members, especially the women in the community, will get. Supporting the women with, you know, helping them to actually, because at first it was just a committee that was there and they met as a man. But IID came in and helped them to have an action plan.
Okay.
And so all the committees have got their action plans. So each community has got its own action plan. And so, and at first, what the committees did was, some of them thought that their issues were similar. And so they could develop an action plan together. So, and adopt it together. So about two or three of them, communities, will adopt one action plan. And by so doing, they share information. So whatever is happening in this community can be heard. So like Wamali and Sanziruba and Dufa have got similar this, because now they don't even have land at all. You understand? So they also came together, and for them they felt that the main thing they should be doing as a committee is to educate their community members so that they can go out and access land. Because within the community, they can't get land.